continuously traits which are compatible with Mendel's law. See, this is the first experiment on polygenic inheritance was demonstrated by Swedish genetics H. Nielsen Egil, 1909, in wheat plant kernel. Kernel color is controlled by two genes, each with two alleles. One with the red kernel color, and the red dark red genotype is capital R1, capital R2, capital R2, and white genotype small r1, small r2. Okay, then what he obtained in that F1 generation, capital R1, small r1, capital R2, small r2, what is that? The intensity of the red color is determined the number of R genes in the F2 generation. When selfed, small r1, capital R1, small r2, small r2, when selfed crossed, the intensity of the red color is determined by the number of capital R genes in the F2 generation. 4 R genes is there. Dark red kernel color is obtained. 3 R genes, medium dark red kernel color. 2 capital R genes, medium red kernel color is obtained. Okay. When R gene, light red kernel color is obtained because absence of capital R gene. Okay. Results, it is white kernel color, right? So the R capital R gene is an additive manner produces the red kernel color. The number of each phenotype is plotted against the intensity of red kernel color, which produces a bell-shaped curve that represents the distribution of phenotype. This is white wheat plant kernel color selected. One more example. Height and skin color in human beings are controlled by 3 pair of genes also, but not given here. Only polygenic inheritance is explained with the help of wheat plant kernel color only explained here. Okay, the next topic, look at here. Extra chromosomal inheritance. What is this? Extra chromosomal inheritance. What do you mean by extra? One more name. It is otherwise called extra nuclear inheritance. It's nothing. So already we know very well. DNA is the universal genetic material. DNA only carrying characters from parental generation to daughter generation. But here, certain traits are here. Certain characters are governed by either by chloroplast or mitochondrial genes. Chloroplast or mitochondrial genes involved to carry the character from parental generation to daughter generation, especially in plants. It is kind of non-Mendelian inheritance. Non-Mendelian inheritance, since it involves cytoplasmic organelles such as chloroplast and mitochondria that act as an inheritance vector. It is also called cytoplasmic inheritance. No involvement of nucleus. No involvement of nucleus also and DNA. Okay. First one, chloroplast inheritance. One example also taken. One, that example plant, 4 o'clock plant, that means Mirabilis jalaba, Andimandare, evening primrose. Okay. Here, he selected two character. Two types of variegated leaves is there. One dark green leaf, another one pale green leaf, okay, in 4 o'clock plant. When the pollen of dark green leaf plant, that means a male plant, the pollen taken, it is a male plant only, no. Here it is transferred to the stigma of the pale green leaf plant, that means female. And the pollen of the pale green leaf plant is transferred to the stigma of the dark green leaf plant. The F1 generation of both crosses must be identical as per Mendelian inheritance. When the reciprocal crosses, look at that, reciprocal crosses, the F1 plant differs from each other. Each cross, the F1 plant reveals the character of the plant which is used as female plant. Nothing, the inheritance is not through nuclear gene. See, dark green leaf male, pale green leaf female, when crossed together, what is in that F1 generation? Pale green leaf. Again, dark green leaf female, pale green leaf but male, it is crossed together, it can produce in the F1 generation dark green leaf. Here, the inheritance is not through nuclear gene. It is due to the chloroplast gene found in the ovum of the female plant, which contributes the cytoplasm during fertilization since the male gamete contribute only in the nucleus not cytoplasm. So the inheritance is not through nuclear zone. Which one is involved? Cytoplasm only involved. Same like that, another one more organelle in that cytoplasm, that means mitochondria. Look at here, mitochondrial inheritance. For example, pearl maize, sorghum vulgar, cytoplasm, sorghum vulgar, he explained with the help of sorghum vulgar. Another one more name for the mitochondrial inheritance in especially sorghum vulgar is called as cytoplasmic male sterility. Cytoplasmic male sterility. We are nothing in this male sterility is inherited maternally. The gene for cytoplasm male sterility is found in the mitochondrial DNA. Okay. In this plant, there are two types. One with normal cytoplasm, N. Another one which is male fertile. And the other one with aberrant cytoplasm, that means steroid, which is male steroid. This type is also exhibit reciprocal differences as found in Mirabilis jalaba. Mirabilis jalaba, but here it is in the maize plant. Okay, this is a mitochondrial inheritance. Mitochondrial inheritance here. Cytoplasmic genetic male sterility is common in many plant species. The sterility is maintained by the influence of both nuclear and cytoplasmic genes. Okay, these are commonly two types of cytoplasm, one normal, another one sterile. The genes for these are found in mitochondria. These are also restores of fertility, that means RF genes. This is usually called as RF genes. Even though these genes are nuclear gene, they are distinct from genetic male sterility genes of other plants. This is mitochondrial inheritance. The last topic in that classical genetic is called atavism. What do you mean by atavism? Nothing. Atavism is a modification of biological structure. Modification of biological structure whereby an ancestral trait reappears after having been lost through evolutionary changes in the previous generation. Genetic control suppressing the gene can lead to the reappearance of that character again. What do you mean by that? Listen, evolutionary trait, evolutionary character, parinama valarchi, evolutionary character have disappeared phenotypically. Okay, morphological characters sometimes maybe disappear. Do not necessarily disappear from an organism of DNA. The gene sequence often remains but is inactive. Such unused gene may remain in the genome for many generations. What do you mean by genome? The totality of the DNA sequence in a gene of the organism is called genome, isn't it? The totality of the DNA sequence in a gene of the organism is called genome. So the gene sequence often remains but is inactive. Such an unused gene may remain in the genome for many generations. As long as the gene remains intact, the fault in the genetic control suppressing the gene can lead to the reappearance of that character again. Okay, this is called atavism again. See, one more example is given for atavism. Hieracium pilosella is the best example for atavism in flowering plant. Atavism in flowering plant reappear again. For some other generation, it is not at all showing that phenotypic character. But after many more generation, again it can reappear in that generation. Means that is called atavism. Nothing. Okay. These are the this is a conclusion topic in classical genetics. Last topic. So second chapter in botany, classical genetics, we have learnt about many Mendelian rules and laws. And then what do you mean by genetics? How characters are transformed from parental generation to daughter generation. Many controversial characters also explained by Mendel with the help of many plants. Okay, Mirabilis jalaba, Samarskaez, and then Pisum sativum. Many characters also selected by Mendel. Test cross, back cross, monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, and then trihybrid cross. Polygenic genic interaction, interlocus interaction, intralocus interaction, extra chromosomal inheritance, extra, that means extra nuclear inheritance, within that chloroplast inheritance, mitochondrial inheritance, at last atavism. Just to go through the content, okay, I will give the questions for learning. Okay, thank you students.